everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about the work done to stretch and compress an elastic spring. So in this particular case, we've been given this problem that a spring has a natural length of 2 feet and that a force of 15 pounds is required to hold it compressed to a length of 18 inches or 1.5 feet. And then they ask us how much work is done to stretch the spring from its natural length of 2 feet to a length of 3 feet. So this deals with Hooke's law, which talks about this here constant K and the force or the work that it takes to stretch and compress a spring. So if you can picture this, the way that we set up problems like this, we can kind of graph them along an XY axis. And what we assume is that the spring at its natural length, the right-hand side of the spring is going to end at the origin. So imagine here that we've got a spring like this, right? It's coiled like this, and it ends at the origin. And this is its natural length. So if we say, right, when it's like this, and when the right side ends at the origin, it's got its natural length, which we know to be equal to 2 feet, right? Because it says the natural length is 2 feet. So then they give us the information that in order to compress the spring to 18 inches, so let's go ahead and draw this, we're gonna leave the left end of the spring fixed in the same position, you know, so we're gonna like line these up, right? So to compress it to 18 inches or 1.5 feet, so we're gonna compress the spring a little bit, but obviously not all the way. We've got a compressed spring, and this is going to be compressed to 1.5 feet or 18 inches, and that requires a force of 15 pounds. And because we're compressing the spring, and therefore it's moving to the left, right, it's moving in this direction to compress it, the force that we use is going to be negative 15 foot-pounds. So because it's 15 pounds and we're dealing with feet here in this problem, it's negative 15 foot-pounds to move it to the left. They want us to find out how much work it takes to compress the spring. So let's get the example here, right? We keep the left side fixed, but right in line here, but we're going to expand the spring to 3 feet. So the length of it here now becomes 3 feet, and we need to know this is going to be the force. We need to know what the work is to expand it to a length of 3 feet. So that's how we set up the problem. Now we need to use first this formula and second for force, and second this formula for work. So for the force formula, we know that the force to compress the spring to 1.5 feet is negative 15 foot-pounds. So we can plug in negative 15 for f of x, right? Because we know that that's the force. We're trying to solve for the constant k. So we leave k in there, and we know that x is going to be 1.5 or negative, sorry, not 1.5, negative 0.5. And the reason is because we go from a length of 2 feet at its natural length to a length of 1.5 feet. So that ends up being the change from 2 to 1.5 is negative 0.5 or negative 0.5 foot, right? We're doing this whole problem in the units of feet. So we're compressing the spring by 0.5 foot. And since it's compression, we have the negative sign. And since it's 0.5 foot, we have the 0.5 here. So those are the two things that we plug in. We'll divide both sides by negative 0.5 to solve for k, and we'll see that k is equal to 30. So given that, we can plug k in for 30, and we'll get into our first formula, and we'll get f of x equals 30, which we plug in for k, and we go ahead and leave the x. This is now our force function. So now we can plug our force function into our second formula and solve for work. So the work done to expand the spring from a natural length of 2 feet to a length of 3 feet means that we need to expand the spring by 1 foot, right? Because we go from 2 feet to 3 feet. So we're going to go ahead and integrate from 0 to 1, right? And that's basically saying the spring here ends at 0, the spring here ends at 1. We're integrating from 0 to 1, or increasing the spring by a length of 1 foot. Then we go ahead and plug in our force function, 30x, and we're going to be integrating with respect to x. So now this is pretty easy. We just go ahead and take the integral of 30x, which we know to be 15x squared, and we're going to be evaluating on the range 0 to 1. And as you know, with definite integrals, we go ahead and plug in the upper limit, or this top number, first. So we'll get 15 times 1 squared. Then we subtract and plug in the lower limit, or the bottom number, and we get 15 times 0 squared. And when we simplify this, we can see that we're going to get 15 minus 0, which of course is just going to be 15. So we end up with a final answer of 15 foot-pounds is the work that's required to pull the spring out or expand it from a natural length of 2 feet to a length of, to an extended length of 3 feet. And remember, the reason that we do foot-pounds is because the distance or the length of the spring is measured in feet, and the force that we need to expand it is measured in pounds, so work is therefore in foot-pounds. So that's it. That's how we calculate work done to expand or compress a spring. In this case, the work is 15 foot-pounds to expand it. I hope that video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!